On today's show, a quick and to-the-point tutorial on how to export high-quality video for Instagram, and that starts right now. Hey guys, Ryan Camp with the Piedmont Motion Picture Company. Thank you so much for joining me today. If this is your first time finding us, this channel focuses on learning and growing as a filmmaker. It features short films, behind the scenes, gear reviews, and filmmaking tutorials for video production, just like this one. So if you're interested in any of that stuff, please consider subscribing. Today we're looking at how to get the best results when exporting video for Instagram within Adobe Premiere Pro. Now I know this isn't exactly a filmmaking tutorial, but Instagram has become a very important part of self-promotion. Today we're going to look at the types of videos that work best with Instagram. We're going to look at our project settings and presets, the best export settings, and ways that you can transfer your finished video file to your mobile device when you're ready to upload. So let's get started. The first thing you should know is that Instagram only works with specific types of video lengths and resolutions. Your video can be in one of three aspect ratios: the square format, which is the 1:1 format, the vertical format, which is the 4:5 format, and the landscape format, which is the 1.91:1 format. Instagram videos can also be no longer than 60 seconds, so keep that in mind as well. First, let's set up our project settings. First, go to your project panel, new item, and then sequence. Let's make a new preset by first choosing the DSLR 1080p format. Be sure to select the frame rate which best matches your native footage. In this case, I'll be choosing the 1080p 30 format. Now go to settings. Let's change our frame size to 1800 by 945. This is actually the setting that we can use to accommodate a 1.91:1 landscape format. Don't get confused by the fact that Premiere Pro refers to it as the 40:21. To save this preset, go down to the bottom of the sequence window. Click Save Preset. Now we can name this preset for future use. I'll call this the Instagram Landscape. Once you click OK, this preset will be saved to your custom settings under Sequence Presets. Now we can follow the same steps to make our other two presets. Pick the DSLR 1080p 24 or 30 depending on your footage. Go to settings and change your frame size to 864 to 1080. This will accommodate a vertical format of 4:5. Save this preset the same way we did our last preset by clicking Save Preset at the bottom and naming it Instagram Vertical. Our last preset is the square or the 1:1 preset. We can make it by going back to Sequence Presets and choosing the DSLR 1080 to 24 or 30. Go back to settings and just change your horizontal size to 1080. Now we have a 1:1 ratio or a square format. Save the preset and name it Instagram Square. Now you have these presets saved and ready for any future use, so that will save you some time. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to use the vertical format, which works well with the Instagram Stories feature. We'll select our preset and bring our footage into the timeline. Be sure that when you bring your footage into the timeline that you choose to keep existing settings. Otherwise, Premiere will revert your settings back to match your original footage. Notice that your footage may be cropped due to the new aspect ratio. We can adjust our footage to best fit within our workspace. And here you can add text effects and edit like you normally would. Remember that if you scale down too far, you'll have the black bars showing in the image. That's okay if you want that. The black bars can also be a great place to add text if you'd like. It's really just up to you. Remember that the video length also needs to be below 60 seconds. Now, let's go to Export. Go to File and Export Media. Your format should be set to H.264. The preset can be set to match our source with a high bitrate. Choose your output name and location, whatever's easiest for you to find. Down in the video window, everything should be good, but we need to change our bitrate. Change this to VBR 2-pass. To lower the file size a bit so we're not taking up too much memory space on our phone later, we can lower the target bitrate and maximum bitrate a bit. If your video is really short or memory just isn't a problem for you, we can leave this as high as we can. Just find a good balance of quality for whatever works best for your situation. When you have everything ready, just hit export and let Premiere do its magic. Once we have the file ready, we will need to get this video file to our mobile device so we can upload it to Instagram. For Mac and iPhone users like myself, we can use the handy AirDrop feature to easily transfer files between our computer and mobile device. Just find your file on your Mac, go to Share, AirDrop, then find your mobile device and transfer by clicking Done. We can also just send the video file to ourselves by using the Message app. We can literally drag and drop the video file to our mobile device within the Messages app. Other ways to transfer the file include using a service like Dropbox or Google Drive. Just upload the video file to your transfer service of choice, download the corresponding app to your mobile device, and download the file you need from there. And that's it, guys. You'll be creating high-quality Instagram video content in no time. Hope this video has been very beneficial to you, and if it has, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your friends on social media if you would be so kind. We have lots of content like this on this channel, so if you got anything out of this video, please be sure to subscribe and click the bell notification icon so you don't miss when we post something new. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, I'm always very active in every comment section of every video here on the channel, so please don't hesitate to message me. Thanks for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next Piedmont Motion Picture Show.